higher blood sugar feeds bacteria, it feeds cancers, and it feeds our feelings of getting high and low, so it feeds depression as well. So my own feeling is if we kept our blood sugar in a relatively normal range, we wouldn't age our arteries as much, we wouldn't have the likelihood of having cancer and cancer spread as much, and we'd be better able to fight those little infections, the colds and flu, that are really nagging. One of the packages I saw we use in our class of teaching people about sugar, out of the first 7 ingredients, 5 of them were different varieties of sugar. The FDA is trying to help us by having added sugar in the new label requirement. The food companies are fighting it, but hopefully we'll get it, and you won't even have to know that. You'll just look at added sugar. If it's more than 2 grams in a snack or more than 4 grams, don't eat it. So the various fats in our body influence how our membranes function, how we identify foreign organisms, and how we fight those organisms. So we have something called T cells and B cells. It's like extra police and bullets, if you will. The B send out bullets that kill bacteria and viruses, and the T's kill them directly. But whether those function well or not depend on the fats in their membranes. So if you have a lot of trans fats, you don't make their membranes optimal. They make the membranes less good at being able to kill or shoot. And so, in fact, you get more spread of the virus and bacteria if you have a lot of trans fat. Those are in processed foods. And so the same thing goes with omega-6s. Inflammation is something that is basically good for you because it heats up the area and you send in reinforcements. But once you've killed something, or if you don't have an infection, then inflammation is just an irritation. It destroys your own tissues and it makes those tissues more vulnerable. So one of the keys, for example, is we have a blood-brain barrier. That barrier keeps toxins from getting inside your brain. It's a very useful thing against protecting against brain infections. Well, if you have inflammation in the area of that blood-brain barrier, it weakens it so the bad guys, the toxins, the bacteria, the viruses can get into your brain. So you want to fight inflammation and protect against it. Just to give you an idea, we have a marker, hsCRP, C-reactive protein, which tells us the degree of inflammation. When we do it with chronic inflammation, let's just say you have a gum infection, an infection of your gums, you might have a level of CRP up to 10 maybe. You get the flu, you can have a level of 70 or 80 or 90, huge amounts of inflammation. What does that do? Well, it takes the plaque in your arteries and it causes it to rupture. That ruptured plaque, you accumulate platelets and clotting factors on it, that causes a heart attack or stroke or memory loss or wrinkle. All a wrinkle is, or all impotence is just a clot in your blood or in a gonadal artery, and that causes real difficulty, just like a heart attack or stroke. Well, what causes that? Inflammation is one of the keys, triggers of that, and you can prevent that with the right foods, avoiding the wrong foods, and a lot of other easy things. It is a variety of foods. One food doesn't have enough nutrients. So shiitake mushrooms, great. Chicken soup, great. Fruits and vegetables, especially cruciferous vegetables, wonderful. Variety of berries, but you know, blueberries by themselves are wonderful, but they're not the whole answer because you need a variety of foods. And remember, wash them well, whatever it is, but it is the greater variety. Well, eating healthy can be very inexpensive. Kimchi, fermented cabbage is about as, or sauerkraut, is very inexpensive. Nuts aren't really expensive compared to other protein sources. So there are ways to do this. And buying fruit in season and specials or frozen fruit, you keep all the nutrients in with frozen, just about all the nutrients, and they're very inexpensive. one of my favorites, in fact, I'm going to just mention, if you want a healthy fat instead of a soy, get frozen salmon. It's almost always in the salmon patties, the overage of the Alaska salmon run, and really inexpensive, just like canned tuna. So you can really do things inexpensively if you want. As to time, you know, it doesn't take very much time to open some broccoli or frozen broccoli and grill it or saute it really quickly, and you can really do it for fun. I love to put just a little olive oil and rosemary or oregano, you know, season it the way you like, garlic, whatever you like, and then you get this great food. And if you get the onions and the garlic with it, you get extra benefits of things that are good at fighting infections.